Alright, I'm here with George. We're going to do Harai-Goshi today. I'm going to show two types of Harai-Goshi specifically, right? Classically, actually maybe I already did this video, but it's okay. Classically, when I go Harai-Goshi, look, I pull my opponent off balance first and I sweep the hip. It's a hip sweep, okay? So as I'm coming, look, I elevate, right? You see I'm providing upward lift with this bent knee. As the weight comes up, right, George's weight comes forward, and then look, I block this leg and I sweep this hip directly over. So that's sort of the mechanic of the Harai-Goshi, right? You want to go underneath and provide some lift so you could sweep the hip, all right? It's considered a hip sweep, okay? The movement of the hands, obviously this, he's kind of given me this complete, obvious, dominant position, right? This is sort of, this is almost neutral, but it's not even right versus right or right versus left, right? He's given me this position because, right, we're practicing and trying to show technique. I step to the top of the triangle, look, I pull, and as I do so, look, I'm leaning away from the technique. As I do this, look, I backstep, okay? Really important, common mistake that you're standing directly in front. Right now, it's very difficult. He's coming into my back, okay? I don't really want that. I want to align myself to the back hip, right? Toes on the line, top of the triangle, bring him forward, lift, and then sweep that hip, and I'm gonna follow through with my hand. Okay, that's a classical Harai-Goshi, right? Kind of easy to do if the person's cooperating, but a lot of the times, as I'm going for the turn throw, George drops his hips, and I'm not able to provide this upward leap, upward lift, okay? In this case, what I'm going to try to do, I'm going to be a little bit higher. I'm going to block this calf onto the shin here and try to lock his knee out and then rotate him over this leg and throw my entire body downward, right? Kind of like a Harai Makikomi, right? So there's this upward lift in Harai and then the type of Harai where you stick that leg out and throw and wrap, okay? Commonly, you see a lot of taller guys fighting shorter people like me, right? And they're going cross-body Osoto, and then they swing their really long legs through, lock the knee, and then they try to wrap it and then throw a Harai-Goshi, right? George would be better off doing that on me, right? And since I'm shorter, I have a very, right, limited range, and in that case, I'm gonna try to lift him onto my hip here. Okay, lift him onto my hip, and then take him right over that leg, right? Provides the lift, and then, and although it may look like I'm donkey kicking him in the leg is doing very minimal work, right? If you look at the mechanics from another angle, once I'm coming across here, the hips come underneath, look, I'm providing this lift, and by the time this leg comes through, right, my leg is not really doing much, right? It's supporting, it's guiding him in the direction, and then I'm using my entire body to swing through that Harai, right? Very difficult to do because it needs to be super precise and the person could step in this direction, now the technique's gone. So a lot of the times, if George goes Uchimata once, oh shoot, right? I'm stepping out to the side, okay, that's my natural defense, right? To throw my hips away from his leg, right? He wants to lift me up. So now he takes that step, boom, and I anticipate a Uchimata, right? And then he backstep. And look, as I step out to the side, he throws this leg across. And then, there's that Harai-Goshi, right? Better than my Harai.
that's a very good Ruke.
Yeah, thank you. So Uchimata Harai is always a very classic thing that a lot of people do. Right? If you do a Harai, you should have a Uchimata. If you do Uchimata, you should have a Harai. So you anticipate that initial defense, right? And then you throw that leg across, right? Shorter, you try to lift and bomb them, and sometimes it doesn't work. You're taller, Ouchi, throw that leg across, right, you could attack from safety. So generally, I would say Harai is more suitable for a taller person, doing it to a shorter person. But you could also use it if you're shorter, like me. I don't use it that often, but I do. Ron, do you have any questions?
No.
Thank you. Oh, so.